round. Happy New Year to you all. If you like predictions, I've got a hopeful prediction to start off 2023. I believe this is going to be the year when many millions of people are going to wake up. Over the past year, we've been seeing people using their powerful platforms now to openly mock lunatics such as Klaus Schwab.
Klaus Schwab, yeah.
Oh.
This is in Harvard's John F. Kennedy School of Government. He is speaking in 2017.
I feel like we should have Darth Vader music playing when that guy talks.
Please do it when I play.
Can you get Darth Vader?
Klaus Schwab, the Remnant newspaper's Man of the Year. Man of the Year. Last year, we made Pope Francis our Man of the Year because he was the greatest, he still is, the greatest recruiting agent traditional Catholicism has ever known. This year, we're feeling somewhat similar about Mr. Schwab, the professor, the field marshal, because nobody has done more to expose the really dark, draconian side of the New World Order. Nobody has done more to do that than this guy. I think I said a couple times over the past year, we could do shows every single day trying to expose this guy and Davos and the World Economic Forum, but it's so much easier just to push play on one of his videos.
But we have to go one step further. We have to have a strategic mood. We have to construct the world of tomorrow. It's a systemic transformation of the world. So we have to define how the world should look like. But
he wants to fuse our cell phones to our brains. We played that just last show, if you're curious about that. That's a direct quote. That's what he wants to do. He wants to abolish our countries, our borders. That's what's going on the southern border in the United States right now. That's part of the grand Schwab, Soros, UN plan to erase the borders of the world. He wants to take away our private property, obviously, cars, homes. It's all going to be gone if he gets his way, if they get their way. Wants to force us to get injected by whatever wild Bill Gates comes up with next. They want us to eat bugs.
But
And, by the way, he's been wrong about just about everything. Remember, for example, how incredibly wrong he was when he came out and said this.
Nobody will be safe if not everybody is vaccinated.
No, actually, Klaus, nobody is safe if not everybody is protected from you, you lunatic.
But
even mainstream politicians are figuring this out. They have had enough of the crazy from Davos. Alberta, Canada, the province of Alberta, the new prime minister up there, Danielle Smith, I don't want to jinx anything, but she's so good. She said so many great things so far early out of the gate here that there's a lot of reason to hope, even in Canada, under the little ferret. I get the feeling that Danielle Smith is going to school the little ferret on a thing or two in the coming months and years, at least I hope so. Now, she's announced there in Alberta, that she's going to be canceling a health consulting agreement. Get this, she's canceling an agreement involving the World Economic Forum because...
I guess I find it distasteful when billionaires brag about how much control they have over political leaders, as the head of that organization has. And I think that that is offensive. The people who should be directing government are the people who vote for them. And the people who vote for me and for my colleagues are people who live in Alberta and who are affected by our decisions. And so, quite frankly, until that organization stops bragging about how much control they have over political leaders, I have no interest in being involved with them.
But,
So yesterday I was at a reception for Prime Minister Trudeau, and I know that half of this cabinet, or even more, half of this cabinet are actually young global leaders of the World Economic Forum.
These are the young globalist leaders, but, and just blows it all, blows their cover, right? And this prime minister up in Canada is saying, you know what? Enough of this guy. He's not calling my shots. And this lady, this anti-Great Reset woman, she's indicative of the fact that there is like an anti-Great Reset fever now that's sweeping through country after country, even up in Canada.
Well, I guess the way I look at it is that the community that faced the most restrictions on their freedoms in the last year were those who made a choice not to be vaccinated. I don't think I've ever experienced a situation in my lifetime where a person was fired from their job or not allowed to watch their kids play hockey or not allowed to go visit a loved one in long-term care or hospital or not allowed to go get on a plane to either go across the country to see family or even travel across the border. So they have been the most discriminated against group that I've ever witnessed in my lifetime.
People have had enough, friends. And we've been saying this over and over again. So I wanted to come out at the beginning of the year to do a show on this. We're not just talking through our hat. We're not just saying that we can actually, there's a reason to get up and fight back when there actually isn't. And we know we're all going to die. We're all going to lose. So we already did a show, for example, a few months ago on what's happening down in Florida, where the governor of Florida, Ron DeSantis, actually comes out and takes on the World Economic Forum in a way that we never anticipated seeing at that level.
I want to have the values not of Davos imposed on us, but of places like Destin and Dunedin, where I grew up. Things like the World Economic Forum, those policies are dead on arrival in the state of Florida. We are not going to go down that road.
We've got to keep pushing back against the weird in the world, because they're trying to create a world that is demonic in its essence. You see, because they used to make movies about this stuff. Do you remember the Terminator view? So this is kind of the point, friends. We all grew up watching these crazy dystopian movies, and now these people in Davos and in the United Nations are trying to make it the reality in the future. It's not such a giant leap or a stretch to think that we could convince millions and millions and millions of people to oppose this, to resist this, and make the resistance stick. Because again, we just showed you clips of Joe Rogan. Do you think he's a conservative? Do you think Joe Rogan and I would have a whole lot to talk about? Latin Mass and the Rosary and the Kingdom of Christ? No. We are talking about a massive cross-section of society that's against all of this. And that's just the point. And so the World Economic Forum, again, this month in a few days, they're over there in Davos. They have something called the Spirit of Davos, if you look on their website. Reminds me an awful lot of the Spirit of Vatican II. They got the Spirit of Davos, too, that they're promoting. And they're trying once again to convince the world that they are not hopelessly insane as it appears, that they can force corporations to become the new countries of the future, that countries will disappear, and that the corporations will take the power, and we're going to live under a united one-world government. That's what they're trying to do this month. Their forum is called, their conference this year, the theme is cooperation in a fragmented world. Well, who do you think fragmented the world there, guys? Do you think we forgot? Now is the time to reimagine the world. They think we forgot all that?
So what we will see now is acceleration of those trends and, of course, a unique opportunity to reset our global agenda.
They're the ones that were telling us that they were going to use COVID to change the world forever, remember? And now they have a conference in Davos called Cooperation in a Fragmented World. And they're always in with the good news, these lunatics from Davos. If you go to their website, I'll have Walter throw it up on the screen. The world is at a critical inflection point, they tell us. Economic growth is stalling. Rising food and energy prices are crippling the world. Heightened geo-economic fragmentation is the future. High debt levels. Climate crisis spiraling out of control. Sounds like a fun conference, doesn't it? What do they do for entertainment? Root canals? And this is another way that you know that you're being had when you look at these people and they're always doom and gloom and negative and dark. They terrify you. So the only people that you will turn to is them as a savior, as the salvation of the world. That's how it works. They've been doing it forever. You can see this. You know that's what they're doing. They caused all these problems in the first place. The ones they're going to address in Davos in a week or so. Remember? They shut down the world. They wrecked the global economy on purpose. Klaus Schwab has become such a ridiculous meme now, and I think he knows it, that this year he will be trotting out the little misses to speak at the forum, but in Davos. That's right. Frau Schwab now. Frau Hilda Schwab. She's going to be giving a speech, several speeches. Maybe she can whip up a batch of cookies or something at the same time to give the whole Davos thing sort of that homey je ne sais quoi. I don't know. Maybe that's the point of it. But here's the lovely couple. Now, Walter, put them up on the screen. There they are. I mean, holy mackerel. That's scary. Look at this guy. Looks like somebody stole his Wiener Schnitzel. And the bride of Frankenstein there? Well, she's running around at the moment, promising to save the children, indoctrinating them in this new world order of Antichrist. Here she is.
Also, beim World Economic Forum ist es ein toller Job, ganz, ganz viele coole und interessante Leute lernen kennen.
Das WEF wurde gegründet 1971. Nach 30 Jahren hatte ich die Idee, dass wir auch Leute einladen müssen, die ganz konkret für Leute...
Yikes! I mean, look at this thing, friends. It looks like a Hitler youth school or something. And you gotta wonder, where are the parents of these poor kids? Can you imagine letting your kids hang out with Adolf and Eva here, even for a few minutes? And these two creatures and their friends are promising to change the entire world forever, so it can never be changed back. Joe Rogan was right. It's like something out of a movie.
Klaus Schwab from the World Economic Forum.
He's like a bad guy in a movie.
And the thing to remember, friends, is whatever this is, whatever we're looking at, and everybody's become pretty familiar with it, and I think knows that it's doomed to fail, but whatever it is that they're going to try to hatch here, it can't happen without their house slaves in the media. So talking about what we're going to do in 2023 here and now, what are we going to do? You know, we just can't go on being used and abused by these lunatics. What are we going to do? First thing we're going to do in 2023 is we're going to turn off the guys on the TV and big tech especially, and turn off. I'm going to tell everybody we're turning them off, encourage everybody to turn them off. We now know, I don't know how many Twitter dumps it's going to take, right? It doesn't matter. We're only getting state-approved news anyway from these people, from big tech, the folks that Schwab and the UN, everybody else, that they rely on to make this stuff fly. We now know what it is. It's total fake news, right? You know, and the stuff that really matters is being hidden, and that's the stuff we've got to dig up and follow and be encouraged by, like this, which is happening.